Come on, everybody, stand to our feet. Let's praise the Lord here this morning. Come on, put your hands together. Let's give God a clap offering here this morning. Hallelujah, hallelujah. How many of you are glad to be in the house of the Lord here this morning, amen? We are singing this song and say, God is faithful. You are here, you're a living testimony. God is faithful, amen. Let's praise Him. Bigger than my problems, bigger than this COVID. Yeah. And somebody, hey, yeah. Hallelujah. So we're singing this song. We sing it last week. Never lost a battle. No, we're wearing a mask again. It seems like we never win this battle. This battle's been going on for years, 2 years, days. But let me tell you something. You're here this morning. You already won. Amen, because COVID didn't get you to stay home or lay down. Yeah. You're here this morning, and those of you watching, you're able to raise your hand, lift your voice, and praise God. So COVID is nothing. Yeah. With that, there's a scripture that God gave into my heart for this time. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 8 and 9, it says, we are pressed on every side by troubles. I'm going to say that again. We are pressed on every side by troubles, but we are not crushed. We are perplexed, but not driven to despair. We are hunted down, but never abandoned by God. We get knocked down, but we are not destroyed. I got the victory here this morning. Come on, lift your voice, lift your hands. Let's worship God here this morning, amen.
Your hands is moving right now. You are still. Lord Jesus, I am so grateful that over the last couple days that you've reminded me of the story of Jehoshaphat, God, in 2 Chronicles, and how he went before you, Lord, and there was a massive army coming for them, God. And so King Jehoshaphat, he went before you, and he gathered all the people together, and they sang praises to your name. And it says the first thing that King Jehoshaphat does was that he inquired of the Lord. And so, Father, we turn our eyes to you as a group together. We come together, men, women, and children, your people coming before you. We gather before you, Father, and we worship and praise your name. And then it says that Jehoshaphat prayed this prayer, God, and at the end he said, we do not know what to do, but our eyes are on you. So, Father God, right now in this moment, Lord, so many of us may not know what to do, God, but may we lift our eyes to the hills. May we lift our eyes to the heavens and look to you, Father God, because we do not know what to do, but our eyes are fixed on you, Father. And if our eyes are fixed on you, then you will answer, you will guide, you will direct, you will comfort. You will pour your presence over us. And Father God, when that story continues on, Lord Jesus, and there's a person that stands up and prophesies and brings a message from the Lord that says, this battle is not something that you will have to fight, King Jehoshaphat, and all the people of Judah. You will not have to fight this because the Lord will go out and fight for you, and then you will have the victory through the Lord. So Father God, that's what we're asking for, Father. So often we don't know how to fight. We don't know where to turn. So Father God, we are keeping this church right now, South Point Christian Center. We stand before you. Your children stand before you, gathered before you. We inquire of the Lord, show us, God. Show us what to do. Show us your glory. Show us how you're working, Father. You are mighty and great, and you never allow anything to go to waste. So you are working through all of the insanity that's happening in the world right now. So we believe that, and we fix our eyes on you, God. And I know that, Father, you are saying to us, you will not have to fight this battle. I am fighting it for you. I am fighting it around you. I am fighting it for you. So, Father God, for anybody that's in this room that feels that they are fighting, and Lord Jesus, the last 3 days in my life and in our family's life has been a battle, God. And Lord, I thank you, God, that you are with us, that every time we received a phone call with bad news and then another phone call with more bad news and then another phone call with more bad news over the last 3 days, Lord Jesus, I pray that you gave us moments of joy in the midst of it, Lord. In the midst of the chaos and the uncertainty of the confusion, Lord God, you bring clarity as only you can. So, Father, will you continue to fight for each of us, Lord? As the battle wages, as the evil tries to take us, Satan tries to take this world down, Father, we trust you to continue fighting the battle, Father. And we ask you to use us, Lord God, as you will. We are your tools. We are your vessels. So, Father, I pray right now that you would change our hearts, God, that any of the hard edges, the critical, the cynicism, that is so easy to fall into in the last year especially, I pray that you would root that out of us, God, that we would come before you with pure hearts and clean hands, Lord, and that you would change our heart to be more like you, Father. You'd help us to see what you're doing, God, instead of just keeping our eyes on the insanity of this world. Thank you, Jesus.
We give you our lives today, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Well, I know this. As Denise shared, we ourselves came here this week with a whole bunch of twists and turns in our lives. We came here with a whole bunch of pressing needs. I know a bunch of us here are pressing needs, not just with this, but way beyond that. So we want to lift up those prayers right now. If you came here with something that's just on your heart, something that you just need to give over to the Lord, something that you need God to answer you, because you know that there's no other place you can go. No other place in the Lord's hands is actually the best place. So we want to lift up those needs right now. Lord, we come here. God, whether we've been experiencing fear and anxiety, whether we've been dealing with family issues, financial issues, physical issues, whatever issues we're dealing with, wanting to see family members come to know you, praying for salvation, and feeling exhausted because we haven't seen it yet. God, we place those in your hands. Whether it's ourselves, our family, our friends, whether it's our neighbors, whatever those needs are, we place them in your hands. Because that's where they're supposed to be. And we ask you, the God who answers prayer, the God who performs miracles, the God who is there, who has never lost a battle, we ask you to answer in ways that we didn't even expect. Please take care of those needs, Lord. And be with us as we continue to navigate forward. We love you so much, Lord. We thank you. In Jesus Christ's holy name. Amen. Amen. Well, I'd like to ask for you at this time to just take a moment where you're seated. Turn and say hello to a couple of people around you.